Coming to Antigua for the Women's Voice in Leadership Caribbean Convening has been, it's been a homecoming for me. My name is Carrie Jo Ford Lynn, and I am with the Astraea Lesbian Foundation for Justice.
Convening for me is really motivational. I particularly love this convening because it's talking about support for the work that we do. It's always our prayer to get that support consistently.
This convening is an opportunity for us as Astraea to learn about the Caribbean feminist movement and to collectively design a process that keeps in consideration the priorities of women's rights organizations and LBT organizations in the Caribbean.
Two of the words in the name, voice and leadership. Because in the region, often women's voices are just absent from many leadership spaces. But then there are other women whose voices, whose presence are even more invisible. And they make up our most vulnerable communities. Women living in poverty, women raising households alone, and then there are women who are members of the LGBT community.
So over the course of 2 days, we've had a number of different activities that have helped us to really think about not only the Women's Voice and Leadership program, but also how we think about resources in the region. So one of those activities was the money tree, and that simply encouraged us to ask the question of where is the money. I learned a lot from that exercise because I was able to see where there's government funding in place, where there's private sector and corporate funding in place, where there's institutional funding in place. And it also really confirmed that there are very few feminist funders in our region.
I really want that our work in the region prioritizes economic justice. And I would like to see that out of this meeting is an intersection of those issues, but always with a focus on how do we empower women across class to be able to exercise a say over the economic decision-making in our societies.
The other activity that we led was how we weave the web, and that allowed us to be able to see how different people in the room have been part of the Women's Voice and Leadership journey. So it started with colleagues talking about the history of MATCH in the Caribbean, an organization based in Canada.
Many of our activists and feminists in the space work as a volunteer, and it means that we're not taking as much care of ourselves as we can, and we need to be able to see that there's opportunities for sustainable growth, development, and work that is very meaningful to us.
This meeting was important because it marks the beginning of an opportunity for grant making, networking, and building relationships to further the work that we do as a movement, and as a feminist movement in the Caribbean.
It's about changing. It's about changing the status quo. It's about saying, okay, we need to be a part of it in order to make all our societies better. So it's not just about women trying to get things better for women. It's just about getting our societies better so that we can be more productive. The Caribbean already punches above its weight, and we can do more with everybody on board.
So throughout these 2 days, I felt that we have been able to co-create something alongside Caribbean activists, alongside Caribbean women's rights organizations, alongside Caribbean LBT groups, that is about connection, that is about trusting the people who are doing the work in the region, and really supporting those who are doing the work and have the most skin in the game.